Hey guys, it's Jessica here with Holster Builder and Eclipse Holsters. I wanted to bring up a couple things that about this Phantom that I've learned along the process. I brought it in, well, you know we have it on the Holster Builder site. I also brought it into the Eclipse shop wanting to give it a test, see what I could do as far as making some clear holsters. And more excitedly than that, I really can't wait to do a lot of sublimation on this clear and kind of see what we can do in that realm. I was having a difficulty when I was heating it though, and it was coming out very, very foggy. So it started out clear, you peel off both sides of the protective coating, and then when I put it into the heat press for my regular amount of time, I was getting great definition. It's a very, very sturdy material, but I don't like how foggy it was coming out. So I actually did some testing on my own and just kept coming up with the same results, or I'd get it clear in one spot but foggy in others. So I got on to Allegiant Holsters page. I gotta just say thank you again so much to RJ at Allegiant Holsters. I wrote to him and just asked if he would be willing to share some of his tips that he has had in their process of doing the clear. If you've ever give them a follow if you don't already follow them. They do incredible stuff, and their clear holsters come out completely see-through, totally fogless. They're beautiful. So I thought, I'm gonna go to somebody who knows better how to do this and pick his brain. So we chatted today. He gave me a lot of great tips. I'm gonna tell you what I've done and changed on my heat press that might help you as you get Phantom into your shop and give it a try in your process, which we really hope you do. So here's the one I started with first. He gave me a few tips. The first thing I did was come in and I adjusted my tension and pressure on my heat press. I mean, I loosened it almost to where you one-handed open and close it, and it there's hardly any pressure down. So that was his first tip. And then secondly, I know heat presses are all different, and we're all going to find, you know, a variance in the presses that we use for temperature, but I backed this down. This is set at 344. Seemed to be the sweet spot for heating the Phantom, excuse me. So I backed off on the pressure, I brought the temperature down, and then typically where I would leave my Kydex in much longer, I pulled this out at about a minute and 20 seconds. And I did a few other trials with it. This one came out a lot better. I don't know if you can see, it had some foggy lines in through here. I backed it off a little bit more, and this is my final result, which I am so thrilled with. So it took some, you know, some time and tweaking, and I'll probably do a little bit more in the learning process, but I just wanted to let you know that we struggle with the same things that you guys do. We don't just grab product and think, oh, it's gonna work perfect every time. So we're here to work through the issues. I'm happy with it on the Eclipse side. I can't wait to start putting prints on this and use it for more of our holsters. But just encouragement for you guys to give it a try. And then if you are facing some of the difficulties that I did, give us a call. I can give you more tips and just different things that I've tried. But we're here for you guys. So I hope you're excited about it. Give it a try. And as always, message with questions below. Pick up the phone, give us a call. We're here working with you guys. Thanks.